back to TalkNorth.com. Thank you for listening. If you can, please download before you listen. It helps our business. I'd also like to thank our producer, Brandon Morton, and let you know if you'd like to sponsor this program or any of the programs on the network, you can reach me at jsouhan47@gmail.com. Well, that went well.
Yes, it did.
You know, Zimmer loves being a grump. You know, loves being the, gets him out of doing some interviews. It kind of keeps his players on edge. He loves being the old grump. And good Lord, I mean, he has nothing to be grumpy about. They ran the ball great. They had special teams plays early. They had efficient passing. They had, you know, they stopped the run. They stopped a really good offensive team. They won the game. I know he's going to find something to be grumpy about, but he's going to go home tonight and he's going to drink a lot of red wine with a smile on his face.
This is the absolute perfect Mike Zimmer game because A, the defense controlled the action. Special teams makes a big play. They run the ball. They don't have to kick at all, a field goal. They don't even have to mess with that. And then he also did get enough neutral zone infraction penalties from the defense that he can grump, you know, he can piss and moan about that. So he can still have some things that he can, you know, bark at these guys about, and he can kind of roll around and grumble at the film when he watches it about. But by and large, I think that, you know, in the wettest of Mike Zimmer dreams, this is like the most, you know, football erotic you could actually have from
him. I didn't think we'd go that deep.
We went
this,
there.
But we did go there. This is the Viking Update Show. He's John Krasinski from The Athletic. I'm Jim Souhan from the Star Tribune. We just finished covering the Vikings' remarkably easy victory of the Falcons. Here's the thing. I'm not surprised they won. I'm not surprised they won by a pretty solid margin. I'm only surprised that they made it look really easy the whole time.
Yeah, I mean, especially when you're talking about playing against Matt Ryan, who has been doing it forever and is an unflappable guy. They have Julio Jones, who the Vikings have always had luck against or have always played very well. But at the same time, I mean, you don't expect them to make Matt Ryan look that bad. And they really, from the very start, I mean, you're talking, you know, Anthony Barr right off the edge to start the game, and they were in his grill the whole game. You know, he made some really forced throws, and you just, you did not, he looked like a rookie quarterback and not a seasoned pro who's played in the Super Bowl and all these other things. And so, yeah, I think I picked 24-17 or 24-20, I think, was my score that I picked the Vikings to win. Yeah, this was a dismantling. I mean, they came out flying, and they never really gave Atlanta a chance.
Yeah, I picked 31-23. I thought the Vikings would have a good offensive day, but I didn't imagine them just shutting the Falcons down the way they did. This is sponsored by Twill and the Edina Galleria. Tony Hoaglund, your State Farm agent who works out of Champlin, handles my insurance, and Bite Squad. Use the promo code TALKNORTH for first delivery fee waived. We appreciate all of our sponsors and all our listeners. You can subscribe to the show or the network at your favorite podcast app. Go on iTunes, rip us, rate us, whatever you like. We appreciate any feedback we can get from you. So Cook looked fantastic. And the one time they gave him a couple of carries in the preseason, he looked fantastic. So we could sit here and say, well, he's got to stay healthy, but all NFL players have to stay healthy. Taking just what we see at face value, he could be one of the top 3 to 5 backs in the NFL.
Sure, absolutely. I mean, he is not just a runner. He's a receiver as well. He today, I thought, just looked dynamic in terms of he looked like he is fresh-legged. I mean, he did not look rusty at all. He had great burst through the line. He lowered his shoulder and ran over a couple of guys to get extra yards. He also ran by guys to get to the end zone. And he's very sure-handed when it comes to the receiving game. He is a, you know, we have 5-tool players in baseball. He's a 5-tool back. Like, he can do it all. And so I think that it does. It gets to the point you want to keep him healthy just because he does bring so much to this offense. And even though Stephon Diggs and Adam Thielen are game breakers, they have a guy in Dalvin Cook who anytime he gets his hands on the ball can take it to the house. And that just provides a different dimension. And it does get the defense on its heels a little bit more. And so I don't think that every game is going to be like the game against the Falcons where it's, you know, all running and hardly any passing at all with Kirk Cousins only throwing 10 passes, I think. But to have that ability to be able to grind games this way and then pound, 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 and then pop a couple of big runs, I mean, you know, he could absolutely put himself in position for a Pro Bowl bid, for an All-Pro bid. I mean, he's that talented. And, yeah, as long as he can stay on the field.
And he could end up being, I don't know if we can say, you know, best running back in this league, but we might be able to say best healthy running back who hasn't held out by the end of the year.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So far. Yeah, he has not held out yet.
Yeah, that's just a big word.
Let's say
big
that.
Word in the running back world.
He has not held out
Maybe he'll be the president of the running back union.
Okay, that it's entirely possible. Watching that position, I believe, has gotten to sort of this breaking point in the NFL where some smart and sort of socially aware, or however you want to call it, aware running backs have understood that, look, this I'm set up to fail in this position because the way that contracts are set up, I get 4 or 5 years, they have me at relatively cheap value, and by that time the tread is off the tire, and then they go looking for someone else. There's very few of them anymore who are getting the Ezekiel Elliott deals, who are getting the Todd Gurley deals, and so that's why you're seeing Melvin Gordon say, no, I am going to hold out. I want more money right now before you use me up and spit me out. And so that is absolutely a conversation that is going on among running backs across the league. And so will Dalvin eventually go that? Remember, Dalvin's a second-round pick, so he's not even making first-round money. Now, he would get to free agency just a little bit quicker than a first-round pick that's as a five-year deal as opposed to a four-year deal. But you know, he's got a lot to think about as well. And so, but I will tell you that so far, talking to Vikings coaches about him, they could not be more ecstatic about him, not from just a physical standpoint and what he brings, but like leadership, work ethic, you know, attitude, all of these things. Like, he's been an absolute dream. And for a guy who came out of Florida State with some whispers about character issues and things, this guy has been, so far, nothing but a dream come true from a coaching standpoint. And also, he's really, really talented.
And you have to love the fact that it's a little thing. And it wouldn't matter if he didn't do it. But I do love the fact he gives the ball to his offensive lineman to spike. That's a cool thing. It's not a look at me thing. It's a, hey, this, you know, I really can't do this without you guys.
Yeah, that's what, I mean, that's what everyone loves about him. He's selfless. He does understand the big picture. He takes care of the guys up front. Everyone loves blocking for him. And he's just such a, already as, you know, such a young guy, he's still just a rock, you know, in that offense. And so the more that he can be on the field and the more that they can keep him healthy, I mean, he just brings a whole different element that will only make things easier on the passing game, on Kirk Cousins, on the offensive line as well. When defensive linemen have to worry about a back slipping by them in the running game, they can't, unless it's third and long, rush with the same kind of intensity. And that will help the offensive line too, as long as they can be a little more unpredictable. So all of that to be said is that I think he is absolutely the most important player on the Vikings offense. And so any way they can to keep him healthy and keep him as involved as he was today just really raises their ceiling by quite a big margin.
Thanks to Twill and the Dining Galleria. I'll be going there tomorrow. I want to buy some shoes, some nice shoes that I can kind of wear both work and casual that I won't freeze my toes off this winter. I have some ugly shoes that perform that way. The cool thing about Twill is I can find some really good-looking shoes that perform that way. Sportswear, outerwear, tailored clothing, accessories, golf stuff, whatever you want, find it at twillmn.com. I'm here with my wife, Stacy. We went to Twill in the Dining Gallery the other day. We saw Scott Dayton, and I bought the nicest sport jacket I've ever owned, the most comfortable pants I've ever owned. They're Brax. a nice pair of loafers that I can wear to the ballpark. I think they're called Tracks. And I bought a bunch of Stenstrom short sleeve shirts to go with my Stenstrom nice dress shirts. And, you know, I used to wear just disposable clothes. Now when I buy something, I buy it at Twill. I know it's going to last me the rest of my life and it's going to be comfortable.
And on top of that, it's not just the best stuff you've ever had, but it's really everyday things that you can wear and that will fit all occasions.
Yeah, I've worn the Stenstrom short sleeve shirts every day this week. When I dress up or even just want to look nice at a game or a Lynx game or something, I wear the Stenstrom dress shirts. But really, the Brax pants are the most comfortable I've ever worn. They are more comfortable than jeans. I never thought I'd have anything more comfortable than a broken-in pair of jeans.
And he keeps saying that, Scott, so thank you very much.
Twill in the Dining Galleria, twillmn.com, Twill on Instagram. So, pretty good day for the Viking decision makers. And listen, everything we say, the context is one game.
Yes.
You know, and we've seen Viking teams and teams in all sports and across this league have a good week one and fall apart. I don't think that's going to happen, but the context is, yes, just one good week and that's all it is. But Vedvik, terrible day.
Terrible day.
You know, and they didn't attempt any field goals, but they didn't have any snafus on extra points. Colquitt punted very well today. Sandejo had a really big missed tackle. Anthony Harris had a great game, and he's one of those guys who every time they played him in the past, he's played well, and you always wonder, why aren't they just starting the guy? Now they start him, he performs. So, you know, long way to go here, but I think Spielman's going home with a smile on his face as well.
Yeah, I think he's feeling really good right now in terms of some of those things. And you know, when we talk about some of the mistakes that have been made on the roster, whether it was at quarterback with Ponder or Vedvik or, you know, Carlson, all these, you know, the kicking game and a few of these other situations, Laquan Treadwell, another mistake. A lot of times that would be enough to get someone fired, but Rick Spielman has on his side of the ledger Anthony Barr, Linval Joseph, Danielle Hunter, Stefan Diggs, Adam Thielen, you know, Anthony Harris is another one. I mean, they have so many of these guys that have either been high picks that have worked out, have been free agents that have worked out, or have been low picks or undrafteds that have turned into really good players. And that is a hard thing to do. And that is one of the reasons that they do get the benefit of the doubt from the Will family is because they have unearthed some of these talents. Anthony Harris is absolutely one of them, a guy who came in, was a practice squad guy, has worked his way up into a position where he is now a starter, has two interceptions. And you talk to some of the other players on the Vikings defense, Eric Kendricks could not have raved more about Anthony Harris and the work that he's put in over the last couple of years to get himself into this position. That kind of stuff resonates with teammates when they see guys who put in that work and then also are rewarded for it. I mean, the coaches, to their credit, have now turned this thing over to him. And so that is absolutely something that you look at in the evaluation of the job that Mike Zimmer and his coaching staff and Rick Spielman and his scouting staff are doing. They have had a lot of hits on lower round picks, on undrafted guys, and so that really does help them for sure.
I want to thank Bite Squad. Also want to thank Tony Hoaglund, your State Farm agent in Champlin. With Tony, I can give you a personal recommendation. Well, both these companies, I can give personal recommendations. I use them both. I use Tony's insurance services. He also provides financial services, handles my insurance, handles Michael Russo's insurance, and has been doing so for a long time. And also remember, Bite Squad, use the promo code TALKNORTH to get your first delivery fee waived. And then after that, you use it breakfast, lunch, dinner, snack, ice cream, home, office, anywhere. BiteSquad.com. But especially remember, Tony Hoaglund, H-O-A-G-L-U-N-D, for all of your insurance needs.
Hey, Minnesota sports fans. This is your local State Farm agent, Tony Hoaglund. I need you all to ask yourselves this question. If you're in an at-fault car accident and you are sued for $700,000, how much of that $700,000 will my current insurance company pay? If you are unsure or can't answer all $700,000, you need to give us a call. State Farm has been number one in car insurance since World War II and number one in homeowners insurance since 1964. For a no-obligation review of your current policies, call us at 763-421-4900 or check out our website at www.champlininsurance.com.
So the division is fascinating already. The Bears look like they They haven't coached any offense, even though the whole point of hiring Matt Nagy is to have a great offense. They don't use the highest drafted player.